Today, I thought I would start with a video to liven things up a little bit. That's been our ad that has been running globally in 110 countries for about the last year and a half. I'm going to tell you a little story about how we created that. It was actually in 2016, the day after our presidential election. We had an ad in the can that we were going to run for 2017. It was a nice ad about tapered jeans and skinny jeans for women. And I came into the office and I thought to myself, you know what? We need to do something different. We have the opportunity, not just the opportunity, but the obligation as Levi's to do something different. We are a brand that connects people, and the world was feeling, and is still feeling, I admit, and I'm sure you recognize, more divided than ever. And in a divided world, it's our differences that connect us. We can all connect through this idea. And I was just struck by this sitting in my office, and I wrote a new brief right there in the moment and delivered it to our agency. And the result was this ad, which has had a remarkable impact on our business. We've been running it for about a year and a half. We've poured more media weight into it as we see it working even harder. And it has reminded people, we're not there yet, but it has reminded people, and I get letters every single day, but it has reminded people that we are more alike than we are different. It's had a remarkable impact on our business. We were up 9% last year, which for a brand as big and old as Levi's is pretty huge. We've had 3/4 of double-digit growth on the top and bottom line, and it looks like it's going to be a great year for us. I'm not saying this ad is solely responsible, but it certainly has played a role, and it has reminded us who we are. We are a brand that leads with our values. Levi's is unique in the sense that people from all walks of life wear Levi's. You've got hipster kids in Brooklyn, you've got minivan moms in Chicago, and you've got young people and old people all around the world wearing Levi's. It's an analogy for the idea put forth in this ad that we are more alike than we are different. As the CMO of Levi's, the question I get asked the most is, how do you build a brand that lasts? I feel uniquely equipped to speak to that because we are nearly 150 years old. The way that you do that, it sounds obvious, is you create brand love. People love this brand like you would not believe. I've worked at this company almost 20 years. I get letters every single day about how much people love Levi's, and that's a gift as a marketer. My mission and my team's mission is to spread that love, to create more love, new generations, more people that love Levi's so much they want to tell stories unprompted about the brand. And they do. You can't get in a taxi if you work for Levi's and not have the taxi driver, the Uber driver, the Lyft driver tell you their Levi's story. My aim is to create more stories, more fans around the world. The next question I get asked is, how do you build a brand with purpose? And that's what we're going to talk about here today. And I think people want an easy answer for this. They want to be able to sort of plot it on a grid and go, oh, here's the white space, just like they think through their brand positioning. That's the purpose we're going to have. But it doesn't work that way because it has to be real and it has to be true or it doesn't work. It's false. Nothing is more appealing than an authentic person, right? Those are the people we're drawn to at a party, people who show up and they're real and they're who they are. And the same is true for brands. And Levi's has been leading with our values since 1853, when Levi Strauss himself landed on the shores of California from Germany, and he donated money to start an orphanage. And we did it again in the early 60s, when we desegregated factories in the South before being legally required to do so. And we did it again in 1992 when we offered same-sex partner benefits to our LGBTQ employees before marriage equality was even a thing that anybody talked about. Doing the right thing is not always easy, and sometimes it affects our business, but we have done it over the course of time. We have stood for our values, empathy, integrity, courage, and originality. And as I said, sometimes it has an adverse impact on our business. In the early 90s, we defunded the Boy Scouts when they banned gay scout leaders. We did it because it was the right thing to do. It absolutely affected our business in the short term. But here we are, 145 years old, with more love than ever. So if you take the long view and you do the right thing and you stand by your employees, because that's what this is about, and you stand by your consumers, and you can just sort of plow through the short-term, potentially adverse impacts. At the end of the day, you do have the opportunity, one, to help drive social progress, but also to create a deep and abiding love for your brand. And that's what Levi's has done. We have led with our values, and we've done it centered around two issues, and that's what I'm going to talk about. The issues that we have tended to focus on, or that we do focus on, are sustainability and equality. And the reason we focus our efforts there, sustainability, that's all about how we make our products, right? That's about how we make our blue jeans. And we want to do it in a way that creates less impact and ultimately no impact on the earth. So we're leaving this world a better place than we found it. Equality is where we are focused because that's about who makes our products and who wears our products. It's really simple. These two areas make sense for us. It's about treating those people who work for us, who make our products at factories that we don't even own, with respect and with equality, and ensuring that the people that love to wear our products around the world know that when they do, Levi's is a symbol of their values. We lean into the fact that Levi's is a global beacon, and we punch above our weight class if you just look at it in terms of our size. But in terms of what we represent in the world, we stand for American values, the best of American values, which is not always the case right now when we think about America and the role we're playing in the world. But if you think about the best of what it means to be American, right? It's about inclusiveness. It's about democracy. It's about equality. It's about social progress and innovation. And it's about hope for a brighter future, which is exactly what Levi Strauss had in mind when he left his home of Bavaria, which is now Germany, and came to California. He was attempting to build a better life and a better future for himself and his family. When we don't lean into these values, and you know, 145 years, it's a long time to be around, right? And so it's not always been good. It's not always been up. It's up right now. We have a lot of momentum and a lot of love. When we don't lean into our values, we falter. We are at our best when we assert our values with courage. I'm going to talk about four sort of areas that we focus on. The first is worker well-being. And again, this is about how we make our products. In the early 90s, when owned and operated factories were becoming a bit of a thing of the past and everybody was shipping their production overseas, we felt it was really important that we still make sure that we ensure that the workers, the people, the factory workers who make our jeans, who drive our sales and profitability, that they are treated with respect, that they have safe working conditions. So we developed terms of engagement, really disciplined and rigorous terms of engagement. And every factory that we partner with in all of the countries around the world that we make product in, they have to deliver on this really rigorous set of terms of engagement. But we didn't stop with us. We brought the competition along. So we worked with companies like The Gap, with companies like Nike, to ensure that they also adopted these terms of engagement to ensure safe working conditions for factory workers around the world. We followed that up in 2011 with our worker well-being program. This is a program that goes beyond the factory walls. So we work with factory workers in communities around the world to say, what do you need in your community? What would make this a better place to live? Do you need financial education, childcare? Is water a problem? We work with them to improve their communities so that the lives of the factory workers are improved outside of their working environment. We launched this in 2011. It impacts about 100,000 factory workers today in 12 countries. And our goal is that by 2020, 80% of our products are made in worker well-being factories. The second area is sustainability. The most obvious thing I'll point to is our waterless finishing process. I don't know if you know it, but these finishes on your jeans that you like, the really worn-in ones, the one with lots of holes, all that stuff, they actually take a lot of water to make. And so we pioneered and innovated a new process that we call waterless finishing in 2011. And it uses 96% less water in the finishing process, which is pretty remarkable. We've saved 2 billion liters of water to date with waterless finishing, and about 70% of our products are made using this approach. We aim for that number to be 80% by 2020, and we've open sourced the technology so that everybody who makes jeans can use the same approach. So we have a greater impact or less of an impact, depending on how you look at it, on the world and on the earth. Third area is equality. This one's near and dear to my heart, and it's so much a part of who we are and what we do and how we show up. In the early 60s, as I mentioned, we desegregated factories in the South before being legally required to do so. We introduced same-sex partner benefits. In 1992, we were the first Fortune 500 company to do so. In 2007, we filed an amicus brief with the state of California in support of marriage equality. We continue to fight for LGBTQ rights today. Women's equality, also important to us. We partner with the UN to support the Women's Empowerment Principles, which is all about a fair and equitable workplace for women. And every March, the brand, the Levi's brand, puts into the market a program called I Shape My World, which celebrates women from around the world who impact the world in big and small ways to make it better, to make it a better place. Last year, one of our films from America featured Tarana Burke, and we recently won a Clio for that. We continue in the fight for equality. The last area I'll speak about is self-expression. This is really what the brand stands for. Some of the stuff I talked about are company policies and company practices, but the Levi's brand stands for authentic self-expression. It stands for that not because I say so, but because consumers around the world have told me that. When we travel around the world, that's what we hear. We hear from people. I am the best and most authentic version of myself when I wear Levi's. I am the version of myself that can go into the world and kick ass and take names. Not the authentic version that sits home watching Netflix and eating Cheetos. The version that goes into the world and makes shit happen. That's what people tell me. That's how they feel when they wear Levi's. So we want to continue to foster that. So in 2015, we launched the Levi's Music Project. We launched it with Alicia Keys at a high school in Brooklyn. And really, the aim is very simple. It's to bring music education back to kids in schools. It's been cut in schools all around the world. Every country around the world is cutting music education. So we work with artists like Alicia. We've also worked with Snoop. We worked with Vince Staples, SZA, and artists in 10 other countries around the world to reintroduce music into schools and community centers. This is a program I am incredibly proud of, and we will continue it. The first school that we launched in, the Edward R. Murrow High School in Brooklyn with Alicia Keys, we committed to 3 years. We built a music studio. We introduced 30 computers. We hired a teacher. We paid for 3 years of that program, and we just re-upped for another 3. So we look at this as something, this is a long-term commitment on the part of the brand. So those are the 4 areas of focus for us. I will leave you with a few thoughts. This is a quote from Bob Haas. He's a direct descendant of Levi Strauss himself, great, 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 I don't know how many greats, nephew of Levi Strauss, former chairman, former CEO, and a friend. And I told him I was going to quote him this morning, and he was very pleased. Levi's is at its best when it is the embodiment of the energy and events of our time. When we fail to do this, we falter, we stumble, we absolutely do. And this picture here, and I think Bonin mentioned this earlier, but this is a photo the day the Berlin Wall came down. And if those men turn around, you'll see that many of them are wearing Levi's. Now, we claim no, we don't sort of claim any credit for this. That would be absurd. This is a political movement towards democracy. That being said, I don't think it's an accident they were wearing Levi's either. Because as I said, Levi's has come to stand for these great American democratic values about inclusion and progress and future-facing optimism. And when everybody at Woodstock in 1969, almost 50 years ago, also wore Levi's or nothing, because that was basically it. That was the outfit, either Levi's or nothing. And that's true today at Coachella as well, not too far from here. It's not an accident that those men and women in 1969 were wearing Levi's, because they were there for peace. Yeah, they heard some great music, but that's why they were there, right? They were standing for peace. And so we are at our best when we do this, when we embody the energy and events of our time. And so today I leave you with one thought. The midterm elections are upon us. As I told you, Levi's is all about self-expression. There is no purer form of self-expression than your vote. Our electorate, 40% of people in our electorate do not show up to vote. That is the lowest turnout of any developed nation. That's pathetic. Today is National Voter Registration Day. If you are not registered, I encourage you to do so. You can do it at levi.com. You can go anywhere. I don't care where you do it, but you need to register. But this is why being a part of the conversation, being a part of the push for social good, that's what our most recent voter campaign is about. It's about voter participation. It's not about partisanship. It's about getting more people to participate in the democratic process, because it doesn't work if you don't participate. And so we've got t-shirts, and all the proceeds go to Rock the Vote. They're out fighting voter suppression. We have given our employees time off to register people to vote. Our employees have 5 hours off on the day, on election day, so that they can go vote. And we have also introduced a new campaign. There's a lot more stuff that we did, but that's just the short list. And we launched an ad 2 days ago. I'm going to show you a long form now that nobody's seen yet. It's not even color corrected, so I apologize. It's a little dark, but if you could run the video.
In Florida, Virginia, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, New Hampshire, Michigan as well.
You better think about what you're trying to do to me. Think, let your mind go, let yourself be free. I ain't no psychiatrist, I ain't no doctor with degrees. But it don't take too much time to see what you're doing.
Use your voice, use your vote. Thank you. Thanks so much.